So problem number 4, as I told you, find two non-zero polynomials f of x and g of x, this is g of x, in z12 of x such that f of x, g of x is equal to 0. So solution, we know z12. So what is z12? A set containing 0 to 11 elements. So totally you will be having 12 elements starting from 0 ending at 11. So what is your f of x and g of x? We got to consider this in your z12 of x. So always choose a number which is less than that 12. As I told you, you can go with 8 also. They have chosen 8 here and they have chosen 3, 4. Okay, we know that there are non-zero polynomials. Try to take up anything, no restrictions in the past, you just multiply them and the answer will be 3x square into 4x plus 8, which is equal to 3x square into 4x will give you 12x cube plus 3x square into 8 will give you 24x square. So 12 is perfectly divisible by the modulo 12. So what is the remainder? 0. So 24 is also perfectly divisible by 12. So the remainder is 0. So both the cases you are getting the remainder as 0. So totally 0 plus 0 is going to be 0. So hence f of x and g of x are non-zero polynomials, but whereas it is a zero polynomial in z12 of x. Able to understand? So the contrast of the previous problem, there we had chosen any type of polynomials you can choose such that the product, okay, the product exists, and under the particular modulo, if I wanted to be zero, if you want to get an answer as zero, you choose accordingly the perfect factors which can be divisible by 2. If it is not equal to 0, choose a number which is not divisible by 10. So likewise, you can continue with this particular problem. So the end of this particular problem number 4. So now next we'll just discuss a theorem called as reducibility test. Okay. So this also comes under irreducible and reducible polynomial topic. So let f be a field and f of x belongs to capital F of x. Then there are two conditions that get satisfied. F of x is of degree 1, then f of x is reducible. So whenever I say a polynomial is of degree 1, it is irreducible. If f of x is of degree 2 or 3, then f of x is irreducible if and only if f of x has a root in capital F. So we have already seen this in the problem. That's why I have given the problems before so that you can understand the concept easily. Then we are moving on to the theorems. So now, so there are two conditions to be proved here. So f of x is of degree 1. So when you have a degree 1 polynomial, definitely you can say it is irreducible. And when you have a degree of 2 or 3, you can say it is irreducible if and only if f of x has a root. Root should exist in F. So first see the first condition. Let f of x is equal to ax plus b. We are going to consider with 1 degree polynomial, always we will be writing this ax plus b. We've already seen this. Where a is not equal to 0. So if a is equal to 0, what will happen? It become a 0 polynomial in f of x. Suppose f of x is irreducible. So this is, when I say suppose f of x is irreducible, then there exists g of x, h of x belongs to f of x such that I can write it like this. So if I say a polynomial is reducible, automatically what does it mean? I can write that particular polynomial as a product of two other polynomials. So where the degree of this g of x and the degree of h of x should be less than this f of x. Is that clear? So where 1 is less than or equal to degree of g of x less than f of x. Able to understand this condition? So it's just mere arguments placed in the theorems. No need to worry about theorems, just plain arguments. So what did I tell you? Try to understand the concept clearly. A reducible polynomial is a polynomial which can be written as a product of two polynomials where with lower degree than of this particular polynomial. So automatically g and h degrees should be less than f. Automatically the f degree is 1. So that's why they are given like that. So 1 less than or equal to degree h of x less than h of x. So therefore f of x, in place of f of x I can substitute ax plus b is equal to g of x h of x. So taking degrees, operating the degrees on both sides, what is the degree of finding the degree of ax plus b? It's 1. Degree of g of x plus degree of h of x, we don't know what is the degree of that, but we can say it is less than f of x degree. So this is highly impossible. So this is less than 1 and this is less than 1. So two adding together it should be equal to 1. So this is impossible since degree g of x plus h of x is greater than or equal to 2. Okay, so therefore f of x is irreducible over x. So we move on to the next condition. Next condition says that f of x belongs to capital F of x, b of degree 2 or 3. So what should be my conclusion? Then f will have a root or f is reducible. So suppose f of x is reducible over f, then f of x can be written as g of x into h of x. For g of x and h of x belongs to capital F of x, where the same condition what we have discussed earlier, 1 less than or equal to degree of g of x less than degree of f of x, and 1 less than or equal to degree of h of x less than degree f of x, because they are reducible polynomials. So therefore, since degree of f is equal to degree of g of x plus h of x and degree of f of x is equal to 2 or 3, we have degree of g of x plus degree of h of x is equal to 2 or 3. At least one of g of x and h of x has degree 1. Yes, ma'am? Because when we say the sum of two degrees is equal to 2 or 3, 2 can be written as 1 plus 1. 3 can be written as 2 plus 1. Is that correct? So 3 cannot be written as 3 or 3. So at least one of g of x, h of x is degree 1 in both the cases. So I consider g of x is 1. So g of x is ax plus b. A is not equal to 0. Now minus a inverse of b belongs to the field. You know that. So g of operating this in place of x minus a inverse of b is equal to, in place of x and substitute, minus a inverse of b. Okay, taking out this, multiplying this a inside. So you get a inverse of b, the identity element. Identity element with b will be giving you b plus b. So minus b plus b will be giving you 0. So therefore a inverse of b is the root of g of x. Hence minus a inverse b is the root of f of x in f. So f has a root in f. Conversely, let f of x have a root, a belongs to f. So if f of x has a root, then I can say x minus a is a factor. X minus a is a factor of f of x. By division algorithm, I can say the f of x which was factored is, can be written as the product of the factor into the divisor, where g of x belongs to capital F of x. This is by factor theorem. So there the remainder is 0 here. Okay. So hence f of x is reducible over capital F. Okay. So this is how the conclusion is. So a small brush up of the entire PPT. So we have started with what is reducibility, reducible problems, how to find the product of two polynomials as zero and product of two polynomials to be non-zero. And then we discuss what is reducibility test. Reducibility test comes under two categories. Second one is let f of x and f of x be the degree 2 or 3. Then you have a factor reducible over f. And the degree, if it is 1 necessarily, it is irreducible. This is what the reducibility test says. Okay. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you understood. Let me catch up in your next videos. Thank you so much.